Hi, my name's Carrie, and my project today is to convert manual brass sprinkler valves to automatic sprinkler valves. And so, as you can see here, what I've done is expose the piping so that I can work on removing the valves. My first step is to take a sawzall and cut out and remove the brass sprinkler valves. Having a sawzall for this step is almost a necessity. It would take forever to make all these cuts on galvanized pipe without a sawzall. A pipe wrench is another invaluable tool to have on this repair. And here I'm just undoing fittings from the brass valve, and what I want to do is save as many threaded ends of the pipe as I can. The reason I want to save the threaded ends of the pipe is that it's much easier to just clean the threads on the pipe than it is to make new threads with a pipe threader. Now that I have the old valves cut out, what I will do is start building my new manifold. And what I'm doing here is threading a 1 by 3/4 threaded bushing onto the galvanized pipe. Next, I will take a 1-inch Schedule 80 union and glue it on the 1 by 3/4 bushing. And the reason I'm doing this is that if I have trouble in the future with the manifold, this union allows me to remove it pretty easily and repair it. Now I will take a manifold T and glue it into the 1-inch Schedule 80 union. Here I'm gluing in a 1-inch slip T that will run the supply line from this manifold to the back of the house where there are three other valves. Next, I will take a Rainbird 2-port manifold and glue it into my assembly, and this will give me three valves in this manifold. And if you remember, initially we had two brass valves, but the owner wanted a drip circuit in this installation, so as you can see here, I will have the ability to have three automatic valves. At the end of the manifold, what I will do now is take an automatic drain and a 1 by 1/2 threaded bushing and glue it in the end so that in the fall, when the water shut off, this drain will drain the water out of the manifold so that it doesn't freeze. Now that I have the manifold assembled, what I will do is go ahead and spin in the electric valves. With the new valves in place, it's just a matter now of connecting piping from the new valves to the existing galvanized pipes. On this tee, what I'm doing is installing a brass fitting that the owner can use to blow out the sprinkler system in the fall. Here I'm installing 245 so that I can get the new supply line to line up with the old galvanized supply line. Another useful tool to have on a repair like this is a pipe threader. It allows me to minimize the number of dresser couplings that I have to use on a repair like this. So this is what the finished manifold looks like. Now all I need to do is pressure up the manifold and make sure I don't have any leaks.